The gym is full of activity every day with coaches and players, and you know, it's just a fun time of year. Training camp's an extension of that, and we start a little bit earlier this year because we go to China, as you know. So we start on Saturday with media day again, and our first practice is Saturday afternoon. And you know, clearly, with the exception of Kobe, we expect everybody to be able to participate to some degree in practice. Now, clearly, we're going to be a little bit more patient with Pau and Steve Nash and Ryan Kelly, but we expect a full training camp roster, maybe as many as 19 people. There are some spots that are up for grabs, but it'll be competitive, it'll be spirited, and we're excited. You know, our first test would be a preseason game or two, but we're also excited and looking forward to going to China for a week and playing two preseason games there against the Golden State Warriors. So,
Mitch, what is your reaction to Jeanie's comments and her updated version of her book?
Well, my understanding was that the book or the comments were made a year ago. But I'm completely understandable. You know, why she would feel the way she did. I get it completely. I don't think that has anything. It would have anything to do with it. This, the Lakers in Los Angeles remains a destination place for, you know, athletes of any sport. Jim, as you know, this is a wonderfully supportive fan base in Los Angeles. It's a vibrant city. And the franchises, you know, that have been here, you know, our franchise, I believe, is one of the best, if not the best, you know, since it came here in 1960. We've always figured out a way to bring players and put competitive and championship teams on the court. And those things don't change.
Mitch, what do you expect from Kobe? I mean, when he should play? I mean, do you have any sense of feeling?
No real expectations. I do believe that he'll get back and he'll play this season. You won't be able to look at him and say he's hurt. In other words, some guys, like myself, when I hurt my knee, I always had a limp. You won't be able to tell. So he'll get back on the court. He'll be healthy. You know, but he is 35, and his game has been evolving anyway in the last 2 or 3 years, although statistically you would not notice that. And even if there is a difference statistically this year, it may be a function not so much of the injury, but of the team we have. In other words, he may decide to get players involved more or do things differently. I mean, he kind of comes into the season with a mindset of how he's going to play. Now, I do expect when he does come back, and if he is thinking a certain way, and we're down by two or we're down by three, the Kobe that we know and love is going to take the last shot. I do know that.
Mitch, have you...
He may be limping and he may be dragging his leg, but he will take the last shot.
Have you explored that mindset with Kobe in this offseason and maybe ways of him being away from the team? Have you thought about how he will approach on the court?
No. No, that's that's really an area that falls under the coaching part of what we do. I've seen Kobe this offseason more than I've seen him every offseason for the last, you know, 10, 15 years. He's been in this facility every single day at 7 o'clock in the morning. So we visited, you know, once, twice a week. But it's more like, you know, how you doing and talking about the team as it evolved in July, you know, in early August, and, you know, monitoring his progress, stuff like that.
Is there any progress in terms of contract extension talks with him and Kobe?
There have been no contract extension talks.
But when do you sense that taking place? As far as just beginning the series?
You know, I would suspect that at some point this season, you know, we'll sit down, whether it's, you know, Kobe and I or Kobe and his representative, Rob Pelinka and talk about the roadmap for the future. But Kobe's made it clear, you know, that he intends to retire in a Laker uniform. And I know as an organization, we feel the same way.
Is it fair to say that at least part of thinking on your end, you want to see, you know, how he looks on Portland whenever he returns?
Oh, I think that's natural. I think he wants to do the same thing. I mean, if you think for a second, if Kobe can't play at a high level, you know, or up to his expectations that he wants to continue to play, I don't think, you know, that's in his DNA. So I think it makes sense, you know, for him and for us, you know, to get him back on the court and to get a feel or a gauge of, you know, how much longer he wants to play and at what level.
Hey, it's Gary Payton, and I'm watching LakersNation.com.